The last four times they've come into attack, it's been with mongrel punts and the ball dropping short.
Proctor back on for the Robins, and you can see a couple of Robins with their heads down as well. Strickland off. Big punch comes from Holdsworth. The Robins come forward now. Thorne has a look upfield. Who's he kicking it to? Kremiscothan. Kremiscothan out wide. Johnston. Well, the Roos come back though and regroup. Gibson gets dragged down with it. And Gilmore says, or Fair said, give it to me.
I think Kremiscothan must be injured because he had such a huge influence. And there he is. He looks very sore, very tight. But there were four Clarence players to two of North Launceston then.
The ruck work, who's going to do it? Fry does. He does it at rover level though, because the ball was only about a foot off the ground when he decided to fist it over the line. But the Roos, they're really starting to run, aren't they? They're just G'ing up their teammates. They're running everywhere to give them a pat on the backside when something good has happened further afield. And they really can sense victory. Thorne, pack tackle, Heard. He's done well all day, this fellow. Number three for the Roos. The Robins have seen the back of him a lot today. 15 kicks as he kicks to the centre wing. Mark to the Robins,
who need to score. They haven't scored for a while. Only three goals in that third quarter, and most of them were early on in the piece. Ahern versus Cullen. Cullen does well in the body contest there, conceding inches and weight. Gets it off to Wade. Wade up towards half forward. Davies underneath it, and he won't let you down. Craig Davies back to centre half forward, but it's all Clarence here. Little Thorne's got to fly against a couple of them and did it beautifully. Well played. I thought he looked hopeless there. He kicks to half forward. Bug charges out. And his only worry there was Darren Winter. So Damien Bug from half back towards half forward. Totman in the way to Johnston. Well played. But he's beautifully tackled, legged, and will get the free kick.
Well, Johnston put his arm out, and Holdsworth ran into it as well. So you can see him down, not too fit. Victory, though, will soon fix that. No better panacea. Cooney over to Holdsworth. He's back up and amongst the football. To Williams. Williams kicking towards Ritchie. Spearman in the way. Puts the ball under his arm, but gets tackled. To Thorne. Will make that Olds tackled, loses the footy and loses the ball.
Well, they've really lifted their tackling, haven't they, Clarence? And they're tackling like a side that finished on top of the ladder. And, you know, it's just so disappointing that early on they didn't play the style of football. Full credit to North Launceston. But finally they're going about the game as a professional side, that what they are.
Scotty Adams with the kick, and he's had a magnificent last half of footy. See his stats there, and they mostly have been in the last half. Kicks from an acute angle. Doesn't get the distance, but gets a minor score as it's knocked through. 1-1-6 playing 97. Whilst all Clarence supporters pretty happy, Dover.
They would be, and whilst it was all happening, Simpson's gone off the ground, and young Nick Roney's come back onto the ground. Simpson looked very tired.
Dodds from fullback. Thorne scoops it out in towards Davies. Davies running through the middle. Aldenoff's on the lead. Ahern's got to stop and prop. Brownless over the top. Good defensive fist. And then Winter off the ground. That was handy for Clarence as he boots it out towards Stevie Wright. He'll have to contend with Loon. And he plays it pretty safe. 18-9-117, Clarence. They lead now by 20 points. 14-13-97. And Reece Jones in the ruck against Fry. And this is not good for the Robins. I think they need it to be a bit more free-flowing.
Got a few tired players out there. Ahern's gone into the goal square. Cullen's gone with him. Proctor's gone. Aldenoff's gone out to centre half forward where he did so well early. And Brownless has gone with him.
Wade ducks his head and gets away with it. Gets round another one. And bombs the old torpedo punt up to the half forward line where Wright's lurking. Stevie Wright loves to handball. He wouldn't like the result, though, because Scott missed what he should have taken. Back to right. 13th handball. Over to Scott again, and the pass of beauty to Holdsworth. And here's another starter who started slowly, Robbie, but he's come right into the game. Kick to Richards. Richards can't mark. Oh, tackled well, though. Over to Ritchie. Peter Ritchie has a shot for goal, but kicks are behind.
Yeah, the thing I notice about this game at the moment, the Clarence forward line very lively. They've been able to rotate their players, and unfortunately North Launceston have had to put their tired players into their forward line, which means when they do get it under there and up under pressure, their players are very heavy in the legs and no excitement, no life in their forward line.
Good kick from Dodds to Graham Olds at half back. Must bring it in towards the centre. Proctor's the one. He can't take it. Fry going backwards a bit. Brownless can't pick it up. Eased out of it. Hangs onto it, then gets it to Fry off to Winter. Winter just bombs into the forward line. Gets onto the little tour. In towards full forward. Richards makes the ball his object. As does Stevie Wright. Can the captain coach seal it? He's put it through! Well, they haven't sealed it yet, but gee, they're close.
So it's a fair bit now, Rob. They've really pulled away. They're almost five goals in front, and there are too many tired legs out there for North Launceston that they just haven't got enough system or enough strength in their legs or even fitness at this stage. Very tired players. Ahern's going back into the ruck. Stevie Wright's just kept ploughing on, and he's been able to lift his side with his good use of the footy, both by hand and foot. I'd say they're pretty close to being home.
They've had 11 goal kickers, the Roos, as Wright's just marked his name into the goal-kicking list. Handball comes out to Olds. Olds down to Gibson, and Gibson marks. Well, the Robins need a couple, and they need them quickly. Gibson centres it. Proctor's in good position. Over the back, he doesn't jump for it, though. Where are the young legs? They're not there at the moment for the Robins. It's all the Roos. Tapped up to Jones. Reece Jones, terrific tackle. And he's not happy when the free kick wasn't given. He's not inviting him out. Only 15 metres from goal, Gilmore just clearing out the ears. Proctor taps a good one. Todman over to Roney. Roney has a shot for goal. And what's he done? He's kicked it. Can the Robins claw their way back into it? They did last week. Are they going to do it this week when it counts?
Well, they're going to need a significant lift from their captain coach, Reece Jones, and even he now has come off the ball and gone to the goal square. So you've got Johnston, Primuscothan and Reece Jones all in the goal square, all very tired. You've got Olden off at centre-half forward who has missed a number of weeks of football. Gibson's trying his hardest across half forward. They need a little bit of zip around the middle of the ground.
Well, what do you reckon, boys? 21 points the difference. 16 minutes gone. It's not impossible, especially if they get one quickly. Olds bombs in towards full forward, but Kremer's out-bustled by Damien Bug, who, as the game has gone on, has got better and better. Bug out wide to Duncan Hurd, and the youngsters have been pretty good today for Clarence. Cullen running away from Reece Jones. Hugging the boundary line, but they've got it up towards half-forward. Andrew Scott Jr., looking to feed it off. Got it to Thorne, who intercepted well. To Ahern, the old 1-2, the little give and go. Thorne's now got it in towards a half forward, out towards Kremer Scoven. But Kremer hasn't got the pace in the second half. He looks a bit tired, he must be injured. Bug wheels around beautifully on the right, and Bug goes towards the half forward line, and he's found his teammate there, McCallum, who sensibly taps it to Williams. Great Clarence build up this, in towards the pocket, and Ritchie.
What I'd like to see North do, because there's plenty of footy left. I'd like to see them, they're taking Kremer off now, which I think is a good thing, but I'd like to see him put Reece Jones inside 50 by himself, put the blokes out a little bit, only have a one-man forward line and just get it on, because they're doing okay across half-back with Olds running off, but what they must do is make it a one-on-one situation up here.
Ritchie from close in on the boundary line. It'll land in the goal square, and it's been forced through for a behind.
Strickland onto the ground for Kremer Skazen.
Well, Kremer didn't look fit at all, did he, when he had to do the chasing then. This fella does, though, Roney. Roney has one bounce, two. He can have another. He kicks it in towards Reece Jones. Can the skipper take a mark? He got it on the second grab. The subtle nudge. Cullen not happy, but Reece Jones does it well, and that's what experience is all about, I suppose.
Well, that's the way, you know, I don't know if it's smart after the event, but get him out of this 50-metre line, put Reece Jones smack bang in the middle of the 50, leave him one out, and that's their best chance of winning this game.
He's got two goals, one in the second, one in the third. Flat old punt kick, looked like a flat ball when he kicked that, but he still kicked a goal.
6 points, Wilco.
Well, you can't exactly say any better than that, can you?
Very lucky that he didn't get the free kick away, because he definitely pushed Cullen out, had the second bite at the ball. But I agree with what Shorey's saying. Clear them all out, give him some space, keep kicking the ball in, everybody run in with the flight of the ball. Stephen Fry's gone off the ground, young Dean's come back on, Scott's come on, and I forget who it was that came off, somebody else has come off the ground for Clarence. So they're ringing the changes to keep the fresh legs out there.
What a game this has been. It was all the Robins in the first half, and in fact for 2.5 quarters. Then Clarence came back. They've established their ascendancy, and the Robins have kicked the last two. If they get the next one, there'll be a real contest on. Todman out wide from Hawkins. Strickland screaming for it in short, and he's got it. Wall of players in front of Rhys Jones. That's where he's heading. Rhys Jones will have to beat the three of them. Aldenhoff makes a contest of it. Hurd roves beautifully. Halm says, get out of the way, Scotty Wade. And then hand passes it to Cullen. Well played. Cullen out wide finds Williams, who couldn't drag it in. Oh, it's been kept in. Hawkins has got it now. Another chance for the Robins here. Proctor or Aldenhoff. Or they flew against each other. Cooney will relieve.
Cooney's kick to centre wing. Todman again. He's lifted his work rate. He's not going to give up without a real go. He kicks to the centre to Ahern. Ahern can bomb one in from the centre. Johnston's down there. So too's Proctor. Jones can't mark it. It's all the roos at ground level. Cole feeds off to Bug. And Bug clears, but only momentarily. Just about best player of the finals, Davies. Always composed. Over to Ahern. Not a good pass to Gibson, but he does it well to Thorne. Thorne has a snap for goal. He would have loved it, but it's only the minor score.
See what's happening, Wilco. The ball's come up three or four times in the last minute, and every time the ball has been in the air, there's been a pack of about eight players. Everyone's desperate to get the footy, and Clarence is just taking the ball away. It's only a matter of time before Clarence take it all the way down and kick a goal.
Young Dean's gone off the ground. Fry's come back on, so they're really ringing the changes to keep it going for them.
Big Bug, rather big kick from Bug. He's been a real pest today. Strickland. He'll screw it around the corner. The Robins have lifted one senses, but they just can't finish it off. Rhys Jones in front, almost caught high. And the Clarence defence standing up, but they're only holding on by 15 points. This is a real important contest, this one. Davies will get back there. Roney Shepherd's for him. Davies again, but the weight of numbers holds it in for Clarence.
Probably one of the best things that Andrew Scott's done all day. He just dived on top of the ball and made certain that it stays there. Sure, I don't know how you feel, but I get a funny feeling that Clarence think they might have it won, and they've stopped a little bit and tried to defend it.
Yeah, but I've also been really impressed. Once again, North Launceston have kept going, haven't given up. Half-back line's been terrific. Too many blokes inside their 50-metre line.
Only about 7 minutes to go of this grand final for 93. Handball comes out from Thorne to Lynch. Lynch, a big kick. Rhys Jones and Cullen two out, as Robbie Shaw was saying. Well, Rhys Jones didn't get it. Winter caught one high from Rhys Jones, though. Winter clears out to Holdsworth. Holdsworth from centre wing. Down to the half forward line. Ritchie pushes it over the line. And there's a push in the back as well, so it's a Robins free kick.
Quite funny off the ball. Winter and Rhys Jones shaped up to one another, and then they said, hang on to each other, there's a game of footy to be won, and they forgot about it. So Hawkins from half back.
That's a good forward setup they got there.
Rhys Jones one out with Cullen in the goal square, and they've got possession again. Strickland's well tackled, and Clarence running out. Slick chain of hand passes. Cooney back towards Williams, he gets a crook bounce. Aldenhoff, he gathers. How he's still trying, I don't know. First game in 10 weeks. Roney, Hawkins, Todman. Vacant goal square. Goes long. Chance here, Johnston. He's got to beat about three of them. He might come out with it. He might have got a free kick. No, the umpire let it go. And Wade clears. He was caught by Rhys Jones. Bug. Dropped what he should have taken. No free kick. Todman over the Proctor. Rhys J. Rather Roney. Roney can go close here. Oh, he's missed it. He was 30 metres out. I tell you what, the Robins are still in this if only they can score.
Yeah, take my hats off to the umpires, though. They're really letting it go, aren't they? And that's what we want.
Great umpiring, Wilkie, and due credit to North Launceston. They've had the ball in their forward line for 80% of this last quarter.
Cullen, what's he going to do? He's going to kick out to the tiered side, looking for Hurd. Oh, good mark taken by Gibson. He goes on to Johnson. He's going to be tackled and tackled well by Hull. Really attacked that man then. Poor players really throwing themselves in. This is a super last quarter of footy. Winter. and over the line, and they're getting the applause, and they deserve it too, because every one of those players has made the ball their object, and they're attacking it fiercely.
And Johnston's hurt. Ruck contest. The momentum with North Launceston, the only problem for them is that they're about 15 points down. Ahern does well, the big man. Back in towards the pocket, Alden off up with a one-hand. Oh, the slips catch Stevie Wright. Beautifully played from Wright. Gets it towards Bug, who gets away from Rhys Jones, and Clarence will clear. Lovely kick from Bug out wide, and who too? I thought it was meant for Holdsworth. It went over his head. Hawkins in the centre. Spearman. Spearman bombs it long. Perhaps they should be passing it. It's all Clarence again, and Winter calmly takes the mark. 14 points the difference, time on, not far away.
Stevie Wright, the skipper. What's he going to do? He passes perfectly to Fry in the centre of the ground. Only a couple of minutes to time on. The smiles, it's starting to be creeping onto the Roo supporters' faces, I'd imagine. Half forward, McCallum, oh, cleverly grabs the ball in. Over to Holdsworth, he's beset upon. Three Robins. The one to come off the nest, Thorne. To the centre, and Strickland takes the mark and cops one high. Mark number seven to Strickland. He's kicked about 1-5 as well.
Last roll of the dice will go for North.
To Rhys Jones, sticky fingered nearly. Loon. Players making some tired mistakes down there now. Todman out wide to Gibson. Which way is Gibson going? Holm misses him. Gibson can line up from 50 metres. Big kick from Gibson. But look, all alone down there is Coon. And he just meanders out of the back pocket.
Go. For a bit of a stroll, all wonky, little kick towards Williams. Still inside 50 for North Launceston. Good effort from Williams on Rhys Jones. Rhys Jones puts him to the turf after the kick. And still North Launceston have got it. Clarence have been defending relentlessly. As North Launceston have given it their all. Kicking towards Simpson. But they've just filled the hole superbly, the Roos.
They've done it really well. Wright's dropped back, Wade's dropped back. I suppose they've put a shut-up shot now.
14 points the difference in the kick out in front of Holm. Gee, they're tied from both sides. Holm gets an excellent shepherd. Andrew Scott Jr. caught one behind the play. And Smith's taken the mark.
Corey Lynch has been reported by emergency umpire Gary Kane.
Yeah, left hook to Andrew Scott Jr. Spearman has set a half-back. Boxing, everything's happening now. Clarence by 14. What a game this has been. If they get the next one, Clarence, they're home. And this looks promising for them. Williams from 55, chips it in towards centre-half forward, Richie Hick.
Good kick. Should take as much time as he likes. North Launceston need at least three goals to win the game. 14 points the difference. Tired legs on Richie, wouldn't be absolutely certain he'd make the distance, Rob.
26-minute mark. Clarence players down in the centre of the ground. Wouldn't be worried about that now. Richie, he's a good long left foot kick. This will seal it, you'd imagine. If he kicks this, North Launceston would need four to win it. Four goals, that is.
Umpire's telling him to hurry up too, Rob.
Well, he's done very well, hasn't he? He's taken about 40 seconds, a minute. It's a long kick. He's made the distance all right, but it just slid off to the side. So there's still hope for North Launceston, but it's diminishing with every second.
You've got to be a severe optimist now, Robbie Shaw, to back North Launceston, haven't you? Because they just run out of legs.
Don't think they can win it from here, but I thought they'd run out of legs towards the end of the third quarter. They've been absolutely magnificent and fallen down up forward.
Handball over the back to Richards. Richards long to Fry. Fry to Adams. Adams terrific to Scott, but what's he done? He's handed it to him on a plate, said the umpire. Can't do that. Thorne runs away from the half back line. The Proctor. Who's going to be first onto the football? Davies. He does it well. Has a look towards the centre where Loon's waiting. And he was off as well. Good umpiring because Wright was the tackler. Aldenoff goes off the table to Strickland. Well, Strickland just gets down to get the footy. Puts it onto his left boot. And there's Proctor, who can kick a footy. He goes long to Rhys Jones. What's he going to do here? Is he going to kick a goal? He hands it off to Gibson. Gibson runs into an open goal and kicks one. Don't give up yet, Clarence, because North Launceston are knocking on the door. That's goal number three to Gibson.
And they've had a pretty big quarter. They've kicked three, but really haven't made too much of an impression on it, simply because they're surely quite rightly called it. They just haven't had the right setup. Rhys Jones, good little bit of ball gathering on his part on this occasion. Hand pass off. Gibson was going to go all the way and do it himself, even though he had Todman in the goal square.
126 to 117. 28 minutes gone. Been a few goals kicked in this final quarter, so there might be 2 or 3 minutes left. Richie leaves it behind. North Launceston lead the next one very, very quickly. Richie was held. Play on. And he kept going, Peter Richie. In towards full forward. Oh, almost the mark to Dodds. No, it wasn't paid. Adams, scissor kick. No, it might be marked by Richards. Oh, great effort. It's all over! Clarence have won! The Roos have won their first flag since 1984, and there's an invasion.
Oh, that's a pity, isn't it? You know, those players have given their all today on both sides, and it's great for them to be out there by themselves and to appreciate the accolades of the crowd. And but very excited. They haven't won a flag for a long time, and you can't blame them, really, but it would be great to appreciate the works of both sides here.
Yeah, it was certainly a great comeback by Clarence after being well down in that first half of football, and certainly due credit to North Launceston because they really didn't throw it away. They had their lead chipped away by three-quarter time. They certainly had plenty of opportunities up forward, Shorey. They just couldn't get the right mix, as you quite rightly called it. They had so many tired players in their forward line that they just didn't have that little bit of a zip that Clarence had when they got back into the game.
Well, North Launceston, you must feel for them, as you feel so delighted for a good side like Clarence. But North Launceston, they finished on top in 89 and finished third. 1990 was a big year, and they had the unfortunate Golding incident and met a good Hobart side and lost that one. And then 2 years ago, they were defeated by North Hobart, and they've gone down again.
You've got to take your hats off to them, don't you? Because they've been the leading club all year. They've been well coached, well led throughout. They've got a good crop of young blokes they've coming through, and they weren't in the game, but the character of their club and their spirit that's been there pulled them through. And like, congratulations to Stevie Wright. He's come here, and it's a difficult move to come and bring your family here, and it needs to be applauded, as is David Bruce Jones. He can be very proud of his team, but obviously be very disappointed. But North Launceston were magnificent today. No consolation for losing. That's three they've lost, but they'll bob up again, and they'll get in another grand final, and maybe next time they do, they'll win.
Well, Stephen Wright deserves all the plaudits. Not much has been said about his role this year. He's come down here. He's a quiet man, but one that shows a great deal of quiet steel and determination, and obviously a lot of inner strength. And I'm not even I don't think at the start of the year that the Clarence people thought they could win it, as Hamish Ogilvie hugs Stephen Fry. And we might now go down to Peter Chisnell. There'll be mayhem down there, and Chizza is amongst it. Down to you, Chizza.
Yes, mate. I've got Matthew Jones. Well, Matthew, you're finally there, mate.
Well, it's a brilliant feeling, isn't it? Never felt so good before in my life.
Mate, you seem to have more legs than them in the finish.
Yeah. I think our fitness pulled through.
Did Steve mention that during the call?
Yeah, we'll drag him down after a while, you know.
Well, congratulations, young man.
Thanks,
great stuff.
Thanks.
Good effort.
Matthew Jones.
Peter Chisnell there with Matthew Jones, and Andrew Scott gets a hug. He was a bit disappointing early, but did some good things with the revival there. Winter and Holm, they're best of mates, and won't they be delighted? And there's Peter Ritchie, who came over to Tasmania from Vermont and then started with Devonport, and won't he be so pleased that he's made the move down here?
There's one of the men on the screen. He was one of the guys that really turned it around for them. Once he put his attention on the football, he just uses the ball so well. I think he's pretty happy. Interestingly, though, Rob, North Launceston is still out on the ground.
Well, it's great to see that the girls are involved. I know Kerry Wright got the girls together, and they're just a real close-knit team now, the Clarence community. And hugs from grannies and everyone. Absolute delight in the Clarence camp. And let's now go down to Peter Chisnell.
Duncan Heard, a great game, Duncan.
Yeah.
Being mobbed down here, very happy, mate.
Oh, mate, just fantastic, you know. All the local boys, especially, you know, when you grow up in the district, you like these little fellas, and you come through and you win it all. Fantastic, mate.
Well, it's a great feeling. Go and enjoy it, Duncan Heard. Well done, mate.
I think it's mayhem down there with Peter Chisnell, and there'll be 2,000 or 3,000 people on the oval down there, and I don't think you'll be able to wipe the smile off those faces for a long, long time. They had three teams in the grand final today. The under-19s were in, the reserves were in. Unfortunately, those two teams lost, and today, in the big one, when it counts, Clarence triumphs. Now down to John Kenny, who's down amongst the action as well. Here he is with one of the Brownless boys, Blair.
Blair Brownless, I think, really has been a top player for Clarence all season. Tell us, what does it feel like right now, Blair?
Well, magnificent. It's been a long time coming, John. We've been around for a few years and now we've finally done it. Truly wonderful. It's great for players like Scotty Wade and that. A lot of players, you know, been in the club for a few years, finally win one, terrific.
Yeah, I think it's great for the club and for you. I'll tell you what, you can serve it up to your big brother now, can't you?
Oh, yes, yes. Oh, well. We had his chance last year. I'm glad we made the most of ours.
Congratulations and enjoy the celebration.
Thank you. Terrific, Johnny.
Well, there they are, absolutely delighted. And won't there be celebrations on the Eastern Shore? And you can remember this feeling, Robbie Shaw, because you coached them the last time they won in 1984. And Clarence, really, since their history, haven't won too many premierships.
They probably should have, as David knows, they've got a terrific area. They probably should have won more. It's pleasing to